Woolies had better watch out. The previously cosy duopoly of Coles and Woolworths has got a new upstart competitor. It's Aldi, the low-cost German retailer, and it's now got over a 10% market share. Other international retailers are looking at why Aldi has been so successful in the Australian market. Well, Dean Wilkie, the marketing lecturer at the UNSW Business School. Dean, it's great to have you with us today.
Thank you for having me.
So, traditionally, a new entrant in an established retail market would have a real tough time establishing themselves, and yet you've been researching the order of entry effect. What does this tell us?
What we have is this sort of generalization that happens that your entry position is negatively related to your market share you end up getting. So the later you enter, the less market share you get. So for someone like Aldi, you would expect them to get less market share because they're a later entrant than Woolworths and Coles. But what's quite interesting about the order of entry effect, if you examine it a bit more, is it's made up of primacy and recency effects. So Coles and Woolworths will benefit from these primacy effects of always being around, being trustworthy, seen as reliable. Aldi is benefiting from recency effects. So what happens is people actually go, oh, there's this new brand. What about it? And then they start comparing, what does this new brand offer that the other ones don't? And any difference that it has over the established competitors actually gets more weight in evaluations. So what you end up happening is this U-shaped relationship between a brand's entry position and its market share. So to a certain degree, I think Aldi's benefiting by being the new kid on the block.
They may be benefiting from that, but they're establishing themselves as a very different prospect. They're establishing themselves as a very cheap, low-cost alternative, whereas the other established supermarkets just say that they're cheap, or their prices are always down. Why are customers now flocking to Aldi?
I think you're right in terms of they are positioning themselves quite successfully as a low-price store, and many others are just trying to match Coles and Woolworths. I think there's another thing we need to think about is that Aldi's actually starting to expand its distribution, the number of stores it has. So often when it comes to the retailing game, a lot of it's about convenience and getting your stores in the right location so people can then visit you, and that's what gets you the market share. Whereas some of these smaller retailers such as Foodlands will never get the 10% because they'll never have the amount of stores that Woolworths, Coles and now Aldi have.
When you walk into an Aldi store, it's almost as if they've read the marketing handbook and torn it up. Instead of having the nice music, it feels like a good atmosphere as you walk in. Instead, you've got the bright strip lights and people just dump the cardboard boxes on the floor. Why does that work if people are buying there? Instead of saying Woolworths, where they've gone to a lot of trouble, say in the fruit and veg area, nice wooden floor, nice music playing to encourage you to shop, the produce looks nice, people will still shop at Aldi.
Well, I'm going to have to disagree with you with Aldi throwing out the marketing textbook. I actually think they're doing what all brands should do. What we have is we have Coles and Woolworths who are really trying to position themselves mainly as these fresh food providers. So if you're saying we provide fresh food, then you need the store environment that really enhances that look and feel that when you walk in, wow, look how beautifully orange these oranges look. Whereas Aldi's got a positioning of we're low cost. So when you go into a store, people want to see things that say we are low cost in what we do in our stores, which means you will get the lowest price on your products. So when they go in and see that a whole crate full of cans of tomato are on the floor, they go, wow, no wonder it's so cheap because they're not putting it on shelves, they're not stacking it, they're not doing this, that or the other. And so that reinforces their positioning.
And how about that strange brand of specials you always get down the middle of the Aldi store, twice a week now actually, and particularly on a Saturday you see people queuing, rushing into the store to get those specials. That doesn't seem to follow any sort of marketing textbook at all. One week you're selling the circular saw and the next week it's a vacuum cleaner among the tin of tomatoes.
That is quite weird but very innovative. But what does it tell you if you can sell a circular saw at a ridiculously low price in the middle of your supermarket? It says you're a low cost, you're living the dream. And so often when you actually have these specials, what you see, a whole bunch of people lining out in front of the store, creating that atmosphere like we want to get into this Aldi, I want to buy a circular saw while I'm here. Oh, look at that. A tin of tomatoes at a ridiculously low cost. So it really helps reinforce their position. It helps get people in the store who may not come into the store. And it really is just shows what Aldi's business model is about. Getting low cost things at ridiculous volumes and pushing it through their stores. It's brilliant.
So is there any basis to the old marketing theory that you've got to have an established brand for decades, keep the label the same, keep it a well-known tin of brands that people have known for 20 or 30 years, place it on the middle shelf just where customers are going to be looking for it, and then you can charge twice the price for it?
I think there is a lot to be said for keeping products at eye level, and you can even say the secret is also to be on the left-hand side of the aisle, because that's how we naturally read. So we always start off on the left and go right. So there is something there that says that is the better position. Whether you can actually charge double or not is another thing. And does it have to be a well-established brand? Well, again, I think the Aldi customer has been trained to know that they'll have a brand that looks like a brand they know, but it won't quite be that same name.
And Dean, it's noticeable as well when you go into an Aldi store, no music playing at all. Whereas established retailers, Coles and Woolworths, would often play the faster music on a Friday afternoon when people rush back from work and want to do their shopping quickly, encourages them to spend more. Is there a lot of established theory that says fast music will make you spend more money in a retailer, or it has no effect at all?
I'm going to say there is a lot of research I have heard about. It's not my area of interest, but I've also heard that you should play Barry Manilow in the car park to stop the teenage kids coming in. So I think there is something to say that that sort of background music does create a certain level of ambience that does assist the shopping. But I think the secret to really getting the customer to buy more in the shop is things like the off-location displays, specials, highlighting things, and moving people around the shop in a way that assists them going past more of your range.
Well, I'm sure many international retailers are going to be looking at the success of Aldi and working out how they can get a slice of the Australian market. Dean, great talking to you.
Great talking to you too.